black holes or anything, but yeah, he had mech for his team. He had a great force staff. He had the ghost scepter too, just countering out Sniper and Juggernaut, what they want to do in the game. So really good game sense and good gameplay from him last time, but this time I agree wholeheartedly, Summoner's Rift have the better lineup here, but will they get outplayed is another question.
Well, they didn't get outplayed in game number one, so if they just kind of, I mean, excluding Demon with the whiff chrono, I'm thinking it's going to be all good. It's Hilara. As our offlaner here is going to have some extra help from Goody, who will block out the creep camp early on. We do have Bloody Knight playing the offlane centaur this time around. Bloody Knight, of course, the stand-in here for Summoner's Rift, and you're going stand-in. Well, isn't that what Arteezy got?
30 seconds to battle.
They've got sprint first.
That's odd. Why?
You tell me, man. This series is gonna break me as a Dota player.
I mean, these are your buddies, man. These are your buddies. You can't get into the mindset of Sleasel. I mean, I only get flamed by Sleasel. I was never teammates with him.
Well, he wanted the sprint just in case he had to run away like he is doing now.
Yeah, I guess so.
This will come in handy.
So, force back. They get both the bounty runes there. Arteezy grabs the mid one. Lycan grabs the bottom bounty rune. And it's kind of interesting how, like, this is actually a thing now, where professional teams actually have to judge what's the best way for them to run their level one, you know, just for maximum, like, potential on sitting on those runes. Like, can you get both runes? Do you just need to secure one of the runes? Do you go in for an early gank and get the first blood and try and
sucker.
All right.
He does it every single game. It finally, somebody has the brain to show Arteezy error. He always gets the two tangos normally, and then he pulls himself. But he started off with a healing cell. Oh yeah, he got it on the way back. And Derp Derp's coming over here to harass a little bit here.
Yeah, just make sure our tour is kind of pushed out of lane, which will probably require somebody to come over. Demon may be forced into, tried to go for the hard camp pull, missed that one a little bit. The healing camp is always tough to get, so I don't blame him too much for missing that one. But they may need some extra help for Arteezy here in the middle lane if Rubik sticks around too long. Bottom lane, Goody and Hilara. It's a bit surprising, but Goody's actually sticking around here. He doesn't have mana to be able to stop this one. Starts right-clicking on a Demon. Hilara does not have an impale just yet, and it's actually Demon who's in trouble as Goody is going to try, and Demon's actually getting his way back through the trees as Hilara continues to pursue.
Maybe.
Double impale, though. And these heroes are just too tanky. Goody and Hilara are too big for these three heroes on the side of Summoner's Rift. They kind of get bullied around a bit.
Well, they have two stuns right now. They can go back in maybe on Brax. He has no regen. This could be bad.
Yeah, potentially. They're going to go for the regen in the bottom room.
I think they could have maybe went on a play for Brax there, but instead, I'll regen denied.
So no bueno there, but Hilara is now level 3, so he's, I mean, this is going to be very farm Nyx Assassin, man. This is not one of those Nyx Assassins who gets pushed out of lane constantly. The Earthshaker seems to have kind of given them enough momentum in this lane that they can really now take it to Summoner's Rift, and it's not that big of a surprise, right? I mean, Spearbreaker is a pretty piss-poor level 1 hero, and same goes with Lycan.
Picking the Lycan, you knew that your lanes would be weak. That's why Radiant picking up a Spearbreaker kind of made a little bit less sense, considering they did have a Nyx Assassin, and you always had the potential for an Earthshaker just blocking off. So I think maybe the biggest thing that for Brax is that he started off with the Quelling Blade and the South Shield. So he only had one consumable, four tangos, and that's already been burned through. Now, there they come. So tangos and salves.
Demon bringing in fresh supplies. Salve as well as tangos for the Lycan. They can't afford to lose control this lane just yet. Relic, meanwhile, in this middle lane going up against Artour. How's he doing? 11-3 on the sniper. Relic is 15-6 on the Wind Ranger. I would say Wind Ranger is one of the few heroes who can beat Sniper middle lane, right?
Yeah, it's probably her and Lina are probably my top two at the top. And you know, I'm curious to see how Viper does against Sniper.
He does pretty well from what I've seen anyway.
I think it'd be pretty good too. Yeah, if you get maybe your at least a level 3 corrosive skin deck, yeah, would be really annoying.
Because it makes shrapnel not as effective, right? Because it's dealing damage back to the sniper, slowing him down. And that damage over time of shrapnel is about as weak as the damage over time from corrosive skin. So essentially, the sniper's just hurting himself. Invisible Wolf, that's not going to do much. And unfortunately, the block off, they still get the impale, but Goody will take some damage here. Are they actually going to go for it? Oh,
nice,
wow, stops that impale. They do have the charge coming out. Talera could intercept that. Oh, we actually missed. He was trying to go for the spike carapace play, but now he's going to watch his ally die, or maybe not. One step ahead, right click one. Bragg's trying to get it. No, he's not going to be able to get it. The wolves are going to go for the dive, but Enchant Totem stops him, and now Telekinesis is back. Bragg's blocked out. Can they get it up right click? Sure they can. First blood picked up by Talera, and Goody does survive underneath the tower.
Once again, starting off the game with the rotation and, oh, pick off. Oh, no, the Roshan. And nice rotation once again. Going, we saw it last game, Arteezy getting picked off with the rotation, and this time Derp Derp comes in, gets the kill. So it's 1-0, even though it says 2-0. Roshan doesn't really count.
You know, Sleasel is having a great time here in this top lane. He is going to be going for the early hand of Midas, which I like. Slarn is one of those heroes who has to make a lot of kills happen early with a quick Blink Dagger, but you also don't want to allow, like, you can only get so many kills as a Slardar. And unfortunately, he's a pretty poor farmer, as you pointed out in the draft. So you kind of need to be able to have that item that keeps you going in both Golden Experience, and Midas is exactly that.
Yeah. In my opinion, it's a great item, but at the same time, you have to be really aggressive with Slardar, and going for that, obviously it hurts, but he needs it this game, realizing that it might go...
Comes the charge. Choo-choo! 1437's gonna come in, stuns up Sleasel, Demon. Can he get there in time for the impale? Blocked out a little bit by the creeps. Goody will provide the interception. Nice, Vicious, hitting three. Now the Telekinesis is on to 1437. They quickly pop him and go for more. Sleasel, unfortunately, will not have the power. Oh, Arteezy's actually going to turn this one around. They'll get the kill on a Derp Derp at least. Goody stuns up 1-9. They're going to try and go for the stun. And unfortunately, the Enchant Totem not quite enough. Fisher laid out. No, it missed! Oh. Bloody 9 ran up, and the Fisher slightly out of sorts there. Doesn't manage to get the kill. And Arteezy's rotation there on the sniper. I mean, that was a little bit on wheel. They weren't actually going to get an additional kill. It just wasn't possible. But they were chasing anyway. And they chased
right
into
Arteezy. Yeah, they had this ward too. See, this ward, it showed vision of Arteezy TPing in. And they just got really greedy. Maybe they tunnel vision. They didn't look at their minimap. And that can happen to you sometimes when you just see the enemy team there. But amazing teleport rotation coming in from wheel. But even better one coming from Arteezy there.
Poor Brax. Left to try and last it with wolves. Middle lane charge coming out. Relic does have the wind run. Stunned up now. 1437 gonna run him over with the stampede. Assassinate comes out, but unless 1437 gets a proc, well, Goody! He didn't throw out the Fisher right away. Too slow. They will get the kill on 1-3. No, maybe not. Demon comes in with the hex. Turn around. 1437 bumps onto Goody. And with Arteezy coming in from the side, DD on him, he's going to go for Talera. Spike Carapace does some damage back, but they'll still go for the dive here as Talera's going to get peaked. And Derp Derp will be able to finish off Arteezy. Goody bounce back once again. He's got enough for a Fisher mana. Goes for the block off Don. Demon couldn't quite get the block. Derp, got to be careful. Crazy
Relic
amount of action.
Spawning. He's going to TP here. No.
Oh, top lane, Bloody Knight's going to be run down. Tried to hit the Centaur stun, but Sleasel's sprint was able to give him enough movement speed to stay ahead of that Centaur stun and gets the kill.
Yeah, a lot of action this game. Got 5-5 in less than 10 minutes, so that's really nice. Mega dives going on the tier 1 in our middle lane.
It's a cloudy game for sure.
Brax almost getting a 6 out of that, and that's what they need. Once Spearbreaker becomes level 6, that's going to be pain. Talera, though, he's got his 6, and he's a hunting. He wants somebody.
Looking at Arteezy. Unfortunately, the Fisher is not up. He can go now if he wants to. Fisher's back up now. Leads with that one. Stun, impale, follow up. Arteezy low, and the right click should seal it there. So nice pickup. The Nyx Assassin, not expecting him to be level 6, though. Correct that situation. Oh, maybe not. Actually, that's a Wheel who lays down the counter ward and takes out this ward. Eventually, Derp Derp will get it. I have faith.
I have no faith. So yeah, let's look at the Talera, level 7 now. And Bloody Nine, he's just going for that quick Blink Dagger, not even going for Tranquil Boots. He's gonna have that in about 500 if Sleazel doesn't kill him again, but I would say Talera's definitely getting the better of the two right now, just because of the Earthshaker helping out. And, well, mid lane. This is gonna be where all the contention's gonna be. Trying to protect Arteezy and trying to get really aggressive.
I almost want to see Talera. Well, if he gets like two more kills, he can get a Blink Dagger, but I want to see him rotate into the jungle. You know, I think it's fairly obvious. Once he hit level 6, you're going to protect your sniper a lot. I'm a bit surprised that a counter ward hasn't been laid out by the Radiant side just yet. But either way, like, it should just naturally be expected. Oh, hey, they're probably going to...
Can he see him right now? Vision? Yeah, he sees him exactly. This pause, that's very unfortunate. But... And
so, unfortunately, his rotation is just going to be a bit too late. Brax, who was farming up that camp over there, was quite low. Easy pickoff.
Yes.
But I was actually thinking, Liam, you know, just look for one of the supports here. Look for the lion. Look for someone like that. That way, once you get the Blink Dagger, you're pretty much good.
Bottom lane, charged in. They have...
They're going to go for this one. Telekinesis, if Durban reacts fast enough. Telekinesis. Throw back down into Demon. Nice play so far from Derp. He'll probably die, but the turnaround kill will be there. Demon's going to fall to Talera as well as Windranger and 1437, who's behind enemy lines here. Does have a charge up. Stunned up there. Charge goes out through to top lane. So he's away. That Spear Breaker is just so hard to control.
I think that's more space being created for Summoner's Rift. And Centaur charges down. Spearbreaker is down, but they made all the TPs. They made them rotate bottom lane, so that's Arteezy free farming, and that's giving more space to Bloody Nine to get his Blink Dagger top lane. They should be trying to maybe pressure him or pressure the jungle, like you said. I wanted to see Talera going.
Ooh, he gets the stun before Bloody Nine can get off his own Centaur stun with the Telekinesis follow up and all the damage on Amplify. They'll now go for Demon, forcing him to turn around and get off the Impale. Sleasel unable to get that stun out in time. The Hex goes out as well. We do have Arteezy, who's going to come in trying to slow down Sleasel with some shots there. They're actually going to try and TP up. Successful run. Derp turns around, gets the Impale. He was basically sticking around trying to make sure that Sleasel did get out. So it's fine. I think he sacrificed his life for... I don't think it was actually needed, but I think it was the right idea.
Great heads up play. This is a little bit lack of communication. You're like, there, oh snap, he's gonna do something. Wait, he doesn't have any of his spells up, and he's not gonna have time to hedge or use assassinate. So, hey, he could have told him, hey, I'm gonna TP back, but probably didn't happen in yet. That's why you see Dirt going down there.
They do get Sleasel that much closer to the Blink Dagger. Is there any time the Slardar doesn't go Blink Dagger? Hold up, charge in. 1437 does have level 7 here, and he gets an immediate bash on his Sleasel. The Demon following that up. A Hex and some right clicks will be able to secure the kill. That leaves that bottom tier 1 tower open for the taking for Wheel, but it's not what they wanted. They wanted a pickoff and then the tower. Unfortunately, that's just not going to be the case.
Well, if you're dumb like me and you go for a Vanguard, then yes, but I was trying it out and I agree. I don't like Vanguard at all, and I think Midas is probably the first item on Slardar. Give Midas straight into Blink Dagger or go for the Dreads, Magic Wand, and to the Blink.
Any armlet pickups or anything like that?
No, I don't agree with armlet at all, really. I think you need, because I tried the Vanguard thing and it's just not enough. You're not... fast enough, really. It feels like even if you have another Blink hero like in Talera, still the enemy team's gonna have normally counters. They have Stampede in this game, and yeah, I just don't think it's enough just to go for those HP items. I think you afterwards you can maybe go. You're probably going to be needing to go for a BKB.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Something along those lines.
It is for the Wind Ranger
Radiant's
now,
bottom
who
is
going to be working on a Maelstrom. They have a very, very good Roche taking lineup. Sardar is one of the best in the business, thanks to his huge amount of extra minus armor out of amplified damage, and then of course you've got the focus fire out of relics, Wind Ranger. So that combined.
He hasn't used focus fire yet. That's pretty weird. There he goes. That was took about 5 seconds to cast that. That was really weird. Now they run a contest. They have a smoke. They have Bloody Nine's Blink Dagger. Are they going to be in time?
It's not going to be in time, but they could still have a good fight, I think. Shrapnel will reveal many of these heroes. Oh, whoa, and nobody's grabbed the Aegis! Talera will grab it now. They finally do get it. Derp Derp's going to be hit by the Assassinate. Nice block out there from Goody. The Echo Slam will finish off at least the Centaur. Arteezy comes in, blinks to the right side, gets Derp. Now looking for Goody as well. Blink away from Talera will get him out, but Relic has been caught. He will also fall. And yeah, they get Roshan, and sure, they do end up stealing or grabbing the Aegis and getting it out of there, but they lose three heroes for one.
Why didn't they pick up the Aegis? Was he stunned? I don't think he was stunned. He definitely had time to pick it up. Ample time. Can I watch the replay real quick? I'm really confused right now.
That could have easily been a much better fight for Summoner's Rift 2. But no one could get to that Nyx's house, and largely because of the great block off from Goody.
Notice Arteezy did go for the Blink Dagger too.
Yeah.
It's all about that positioning.
I like that a lot. I think Blink Dagger, I think Blink Dagger is actually really legit on Sniper.
Yeah.
Kind of the same way it was legit on Klinks. Obviously it's different for Klinks, but
Klinks is just a monster with Blink Dagger.
Yeah.
Sniper is more of a like
situational.
Yeah.
Dire's top tower
Yeah, he gets a good spike carapace off. He does have assassin. Oh, he actually blows us. Oh, wow. That Vendetta. Trying to hit Arteezy like that was very questionable.
He's gone.
Yeah, he's not going to get off another spike carapace, that's for sure. Why didn't he just run away?
There's many questions in Dota you just never are going to know.
It's one of those great mysteries of life, is that what you're saying? Brax is eating his way through the trees. Surprise, Derp Derp. Surprise, my friend. Hopefully. Oh, he already used Howl, actually, so no even opportunity to steal the Lycan ultimate.
Yeah. This, just that Roshan fight, they're just, now that you can see, they're spreading
Dire's
apart in the map. They lost the mid tower, now they're getting split
Dire's
picked off by the Spirit Breaker charge, and Talera making that bad play there, not helping his team, especially after Roshan, when your team went in such a bad fight.
Brax dodges that one. Talera is actually going to come through. What a dodge there for Brax. The center ultimate, fortunately, Goody's able to get a good block off anyway. They do have a center who actually was intercepted there, unable to get off a good blink, but will still fall. They do manage to finish off Brax in the end. Sleasel, who now eats his own way through trees, trying to get enough distance to flank. 1437 trying to follow him. The sniper also looking.
And gonna get bigger here. Nope.
Yeah, Sleasel, they'll get him with the stun, and Derp Derp's gonna be up next.
Assassinated
him off, and Talera may still be caught by Demon, who's gonna wrap around from the side. Nope. Nice fake out there. Now Talera's kinda stuck. Nothing he can do. Yeah, that's a wipe. They get Brax, but good, really good call there. I believe that was from Arteezy.
Yeah, this Arteezy rotation has basically been the MVP this game. His Shrapnel is just causing too much havoc. The charge is coming in afterwards just because it has a low cooldown. Only 12 seconds on it, so it's just doing too much work in these team fights. They have no solution for it, and they're trying to chase down one hero and use all their spells on it. You saw them use the Crush, the Shackle, but then when they get immediately turned around with the Shrapnel in their face, and then, oh, this charge is just making me silence. Let's see if Goody, what happens to him.
Artour, man, like his rotations, oh Jesus, Arteezy. He will be taken out here.
Oh, mid lane, Goody. Taking out too. I was doing the moment of silence for Goody.
Yeah.
And I guess it was for Artour too.
But what was I saying? Oh, that's right. Arteezy, man. Like, He's been really on the ball with these rotations. Like, he's actually rotated, like, as fast as Wheel have thought about rotating.
Like, he's more
like Wheel, like I can imagine, like Wheel's just like, all right, we're gonna go top, and Artour's like, go top, guys, go top, like immediately.
Feel the charge.
Yeah, he can get it. Derp actually stole the stampede, able to run over 1437 with it.
Bottom tower
and now
Sliso
is looking for the kill on Bloody Knight. Already blinked himself away and already used his stomp as well. He can get the stun and hopefully gets a bash as well. Needs to stop that Centaur stomp, unfortunately doesn't get it. Talera does have a blink. He's going to run into Demon here. Oh, it's hit by that impale. Nice double impale from Demon. Brax will be cleaned up by Sliso though. Right click will finish him off. The buyback from 1437 though is going to come out. He's going to be charging Dirk. Ah, Arteezy comes in, finishes off the Slardog. And the stun there on Dirk, 1437, turns to help. He's actually, Relic's going to die. And now it's going to be Dirk who is going to try and maybe TP out. Now he's revealed he's not getting out of this one. Goody's got to get out as well as Valera. But I think they're actually stuck here.
Nice fail. Disengaging, but Goody should be dying here. There's another strike and we'll assassinate. Kapow.
What a dumb guy.
So once again, better fight for Summoner's Rift, even though it started out well for Wheel. They just chase in a bit too deep, and that one buyback from 1437, pretty on the money as well.
Yeah, the initial fight started off with Nyx Assassin not having his stun up, so he had to try to go for the attack on Centaur to make him low enough, but if he had one more second, his stun would have been up and he could have cast it from far away, and then they wouldn't have had to chase behind the tier 1 tower. Unfortunately, they did 1437 buys back charge in. Arteezy's
Braxo! Sleasel, slight misplay there. Could have actually gotten the stun, but missed it due to a moment's hesitation.
Well, he probably... there's no way he can kill Brax right now.
Unless he gets mega lucky with bashes.
That's only happening if you're playing Spiritbreaker in SPBL.
Yeah, that's true. Spiritbreaker's 17% is actually more than the 25% stun, I swear to God. Oh, 1437 against Sleasel, missed another stun there. Derp can be controlled by the Shrapnels. Goody, similar problem. They do lock down 1437 with a nice shackle.
Yeah, and that's buyback. He bought back that 60 seconds down for him. So not too bad. I just really wish this Rubick could find a way to steal charge. They really need that on their side just to make pickoffs happen around the map. It hasn't happened yet this game, I don't think.
Do they really need it? What good is charge without
it gives you
bash?
Vision. No, it gives you vision, man. That's the biggest thing.
Uh-huh. I'm not impressed.
All right. You don't think the vision... I think the vision part of Spiritbreaker is the biggest thing why he's so broken. You can just see if he teleports anywhere and... Yeah, you can basically go around the whole map just charging anyone. And the best thing is, yeah, you can charge them. And if you need to seal any of their spells, you can after you charge.
I'll give you that much. I'll give you that.
All right. Yes. I got something. Take something. And so will Wheel if they can, you know.
Necrobook 2 finished up on our Lycan. Arteezy's probably got to have a good amount of gold at the very least. 2800 on him. We also have 1437 who's going to go for an Agonist eventually. There's the Mjolnir for Artour. And Blade down for Bloody Knight. Center ultimate. They're going to grab Sleetzel here. The two-man impale from the Nyx Assassin is not in time. And farther down, they actually have Derp, who's going to be run down by Brax as well. The pickoffs, man. Wheel. Just not grouping up enough.
Here they go again.
Yeah, dive in here. Two-man stun. Beautiful. Unfortunately, the Nyx Assassin Spike Carapace Surge Blades. Oh, whiff! Goody's been playing an excellent Spirit Breaker and Earthshaker, but that was a big-time whiff there of the Echo Slam. Bloody Knight is going to be run down by Relic as well. Nice dodge of the Centaur.
Now Summoner's Rift are playing a little bit too aggressive here.
Yeah.
Nice play from Talera. But when is Roshan? That's going to be another minute and 10 seconds or 20. They thought they might be doing it, but this ward... will it see Brax rotating over? I didn't get to see it. Yeah, he did. He got vision. So they're going to know that he didn't go into the pit, I don't think. And... Oh, Arteezy, man. He's paper right now, but he's definitely hitting hard.
He's playing my kind of sniper, man. This is the kind of sniper that you're kind of always on edge.
Yeah. Or positional sniper, I mean positional.
Yeah, yeah. It's all about positioning, right? You're always on edge because somebody gets on top of you, you're like, dude, you're mega dead, right? You don't have the stats of like SNY Scotty to protect you. But you do outlay tons of DPS with this build. Especially since you oftentimes don't have to worry about moving. That's the awesome part. Talera as well as Sleasel both being gone on here. Plenty Knight's gonna try and run down Talera, but the Vendetta will save him. Sleasel doesn't have the same luxury of invisibility that the next assassin has. And again, I'm just looking at him going like, you guys are still being kind of like picked apart because you're so split up constantly.
I just think that Spiritbreaker's just offering too much. Again, it's kind of like a Wisp. When you people pick Wisp against, you know, maybe tier 2 or tier 3 teams, they're like, oh crap, what do? If we group up, we can't farm. And the whole point of this metagame right now is to farm. So if you're grouping up and you're not farming, that's basically what's happening this game against the Spiritbreaker. And it's not looking too good at all.
So you're saying I should play more Spiritbreaker in my pubs? Support Spiritbreaker.
It's broken. I'm not even joking, dude. That's the... Okay, so Omni Knight is the most broken, but... And then, Earth Spirit is the most broken here. Oh, Talera is going to be...
Yeah, charged in. And, well, never mind. Goody with the interception of the Fisher. We'll save Talera. No possible combo. Oh, actually, Shadow Strike wasn't even up, so never mind.
Yeah, they're just making sure that they're putting pressure on the map. Even if they can't get the kill, that's making Will react to him. So you're getting a pre-farming liking. You're putting the fear of God into Wheel, thinking that, oh crap, there might be two heroes here or there might be four heroes here, so we have to immediately rotate. So it's all mind games right now, and it's working out to their benefit right now for Summoner's Rift.
7,500 net worth lead. What happened to our poor Seder Mindstealer? Guy's all alone here in the jungle, what the hell?
Let's see, what could it be? Oh, it's the Spiritbreaker charge. Yeah, Spiritbreaker. It put him on the high ground.
Probably charged through something like this and knocked him over to the side.
Should have asked chat, hey, what happened, and see if they would have guessed. It would have been funny. Then they would have said, like, something silly.
You really think that lazy of chat, Leo?
No, I don't, but what else? Well, would they say it? No, I think chat's amazing. All right, I'm done. I'm gonna stop kissing butt.
You don't ever stop. Let's be real, Ryu.
Hey, y'all bend over right now just for you. Kiss my
butt.
I'm just kidding.
Whoa, 27 to 19 before it gets a little too weird. 26 minutes in, we got a 5,000 experience lead, 7,500 gold lead. Charge in from 1437. Bumps Derp Derp. He's like, ah, hey, buddy. How you doing? I'll try and charge you. Derp Derp actually seals the charge in his own. Runs away. And his demon's gonna be the next target. Vendetta will wipe him out. Echo Slam on two with the Shackle on top. That is a beautiful combo for Wheel. Taking out Summoner's Rift. They are gonna jump for it. Oh, couldn't quite get the sniper who actually blinked inside the jungle to TP out.
He had 1 second left on the stun. That's very unfortunate. Talera would have gotten it too.
Oh, look at that. Brax actually being chased down. Get him.
Nice play from Goody, and Slardar had the BKB there, so that's why they kind of won the team fight. No Necrobook, no ulti.
Who's a good now, movement? Who's a good
charge.
Movement?
Yes, I you told are. You, man.
Yes, you are. Go get the like it. Go get the like it, Rubik.
Grabs Brax and throws him, trying to throw him towards the tree so the Shackle Shot would land, but never mind. They'll still get the kill anyway.
What happened? There was a fail fish.
I think he was too busy maybe microwing Necro minions or something? I don't know.
I don't know. He didn't have a TP, so he was probably Dyer's dead anyways. They didn't have any attack. Wards showing that charge, though. And they did pick up a gem a long time ago on Talera. That was a pretty big pickup.
Talera. Gotta be careful, my friend, focusing too much on the wolves.
Demon?
Oh no, Derp! That's a bad position. Delaire's actually going to be in some trouble here. No blink in time. That was a gem on the ground, but I don't think they realize that Derp's going to be run over as he is already taken out by Roach on the half health. Sleasel's up next. He's trying to get a stun, but unfortunately the bashes are too much. Every single time he goes for the stun, he gets bashed. And now Goody, who grabbed the gem from earlier, is now going to be dropping it. Triple kill for Artour. And with four heroes down, Summoner's Rift might as well push uphill.
Man, these bashes coming into play. Oh, that's just very unfortunate. Now it's going to be a Roshan. Easy Roshan coming in from Summoner's Rift. No cheese yet, that'll be for the next one. And Lycan going to be picking up his level 16, his BKB soon. And that might be the time to go high ground for Summoner's Rift. But if this show goes to the later stage of the game, I think they're still fine too because, well, never mind. Arteezy's gonna take the Aegis. He's pretty selfish, man. Can't share the love of Brax, who's let's check them out. He died 5 times. Arteezy died 3 times. So I think Brax needs the love more right now.
Alrighty. Summoner's Rift back in control this game. They were dropping the ball a bit by playing over-aggressive. Wheel had some great combinations, but... Oh, Demon's gonna run into Talera here. Controls and assassinate. Talera just can't catch a break, man. Every single time.
Dyer's middle, you know, they were making a lot of plays happen when Rubik stole charge. That's all I'm gonna say.
Yep, you are 100% right.
Yeah, that's right. I better be right. Oh, goody.
Sleasel, can he hit the stun? Yeah. 1-4-3-7. Forced to back himself away. Man, the wolf scouting mixed in with the spirit breaker is pretty OP.
And the howl.
Yeah.
It's obnoxious. Oh, Shackle out here. Somebody's going down. 14-37. That's woo. Please. That amplified damage plus the ags with the
Dyer's
maelstrom.
Top tower is under attack.
Cecil, what do you got? He's trying to work towards an assault Kuros, I would presume, but.
Goody.
Yeah. Man, just pick off after pick off here. Monster kill.
See, they're trying to kill the wolves, but the wolves are just scouting to kill them.
Yeah.
Why is that so bad for them? Bloody Nine playing really aggressive here.
I think that might actually finish him off. Oh wow, 28 HP.
No.
Dyer's middle tower is under attack.
They've got enough long range pickoffs. Time to push uphill once again, tier 3 tower. Brax is gonna pop his ultimate. Just make sure they get the tier 3, perhaps even go to tier 1.
Ah, the shackle!
Brax, question mark.
Like you run away from the shackle, but then you run into your enemy. You're your ally, helping your enemy. BKB, finish for Relic. That'll help him negate a lot of this. It won't help against the physical DPS of Lycan, but he doesn't have the MKB. The Windrun's always an available option. And did they have a ward scouting that out? Or is just Sleazel playing really aggressive?
Every single time, man, Sleazel. I gotta like sneeze and Sleasel just immediately goes full aggro and dies. I'm not sure what he thought that was, but.
I guess he saw 14-37 bottom and he's like, oh, they all backed out the farm.
Yeah.
And then to his surprise, they were all in the jungle just farming and waiting for somebody to
come on top. Dyer's top tower.
Derp's gonna be quite sad. That's gonna be the shortest cliff ward of all time. Well, actually, they need vision up there first. Catawork doesn't get that mini vision anymore. Snipe on to Goody. They need someone to intercept this. Unfortunately, Goody just dies as Arteezy runs into the base. No one actually deals with that. Brax will come forward, trying to deal with the melee. Brax, Talera goes for the hit. Misses out on the impale due to a quick BKB.
Dyer's top tower.
And now it's actually 1-3-7. Somebody can finish off the Rax here. Arteezy still gonna focus on the tier 3 tower and keep on split pushing. Wheels don't really know where to address. Talera missing the impale. Spike Carapace will save him for the side being a 1-4-3-7. Diving in pretty deep. They're gonna force Nyx's assassin back with that assassinate.
They do have Stampede. Sleazel's coming in.
He does manage to grab Brax here, but he needs to deal with Arteezy at the same time. Stampede, actually, from Derpter, who stole it earlier, has managed to get the telekinesis to pull back onto Arteezy. He will be dying here, but it's only Black number one. The rest of the team can turn this around. 1-4-3-7. Runs through the whole entire team. Managed to get off the ultimate onto Relic. Oh, Echo Slam actually holds two as Arteezy. Not going to be shackled by that one. Lays down enough hits to finish off Derp as well as Goody. Calera comes in to spike Careface. Mana Burn, he gets him with just 40 HP. And meanwhile, 1437 diving in deep is not going to get that kill. And throw. There is Summoner's Rift. What you would call the Jimmy factor, I guess.
Oh, they did a great job. I thought we were going to die. Sleazel didn't have his BKB up. Bloody Nine got Bloody Nine got his hoof stomp off, but then he immediately got blown up by Relic. And then all of a sudden, Goody comes in out of nowhere, gets an Echo Slam on them perfectly, then fissures. And there was like six shrapnels on the ground, or five, because Rubik had stole it. So I was just like, who's actually dying from whose? It was pretty funny to watch. And then all of a sudden, Sleazel was dying on the backside by the wolves, and he almost went down too. So really well played from, I want to say, both sides. Just a little bit better from Wheel, though, coming out ahead. And they did bring down Arteezy twice during that fight.
But Summoner's Rift, at this point in time, they already have enough control thanks to the push-in and the melee racks being taken down in the middle lane. At this point, they just control the map, wait for Roshan to come back up, and try and take that one. And if at that point, Wheeler gonna have to come out and try and contest them.
Right. And both teams are gonna be picking up cuirasses, one on Lycan and one on Sleazel. So those are gonna be really crucial items coming up for this next team fight, I feel. And top lane, there's always going to be a charge somewhere on the map or something on the map. The gem is gone.
Can we actually kill him here? Well, there goes the gem.
But
Hex Slash just long enough that they couldn't get off.
Sleazel. No, wait. I mean, Goody. Run, Goody.
Goody, you got to get it, buddy. You got to get it and got to get out. Brax is coming with his BKB. No time. Oh, what a bash. Sleazel. That's quite fortunate. Derp now with the wolf on wolf back. 1437 comes in, pops the BKB, going for Relic. Relic does have a BKB of his own, as well as Quintum.
It's very hard.
Yeah, he's trying to chase it down. Focus Fire. So much damage. Demon, what's he doing here? He just stopped moving for a second. It looks like he may be run down. Bloody Nine comes in from the side, managed to get the stun. Relic is so tanky, though. He can survive for a while. The rest of his team comes in. Sleazel, he needs some help. Yeah, they're trying to chase down Arteezy at the same time. Relic. He still managed, he actually gets a kill there. He'll die eventually.
No, Sleazel slips into the tree. They're pinging him.
Oh, God, Sleazel, why? Arteezy may still fall. They got a mana burn to finish him off, but still. That was silly.
Oh, two mana burns to the face of Arteezy with the Scotty. That does a lot of damage. That's not to be underestimated.
That was like big plays from Relic and Dyer's little plays from Sleazel, unfortunately. Attack. Didn't matter too much that Sleazel messed up his Blink Dagger, but man,
he still got the Amplify damage off. It helped a lot.
He got the first hit bash. That's very skill-based. You're right. I shouldn't be so critical of Sleazel.
I mean, did you see that Spirit Breaker die in three shots to Relic? This Amplify damage is doing work, considering they're not casting their BKB afterwards. They're always casting it premature. So then he's able to always get off the amplified damage after the BKB's used.
Well, Wheel Wreck while whistling, making a comeback here in this game number two of the two-game series between Summoner's Rift and Wheel. It is 37 minutes in, 41-33, about a 13,000 gold lead and a 2,500 experience lead for Summoner's Rift. Summoner's Rift have always kept their economy up, but the last couple of team fights have significantly fed Wheel a lot of levels. But that's kind of the only thing.
I was going to say the gold graph was going down, but it's kind of stagnated for a little bit here in the last 5 or so minutes. So
yeah, Summoner's Rift, they're still controlling the map. And
mm-hmm.
Do they actually have any Midases? No, they don't.
No mass Midases this game.
The only minus is actually still Sleaseless, so.
Imagine if he didn't have that. He wouldn't even have his Kuras now. He'd just have a BKB.
So. Pretty much.
Dagging two up on the Nyx Assassin. That's pretty good, knowing that Sleaseless or Arteezy's not going for a BKB. And, well, Arteezy, knowing that all the damage is coming out, yeah, that should be his next item. Get a BKB. Once that happens, you only have to really worry about the Slardar and the Relic coming in over the top.
Frax. I think they're trying to set a trap here, but I don't think they realize that Wheel are actually, well, TP out. Goody is smoke popped, but I don't think he really realizes what's happening here. 1-4-3-7 is found. Instant Echo Slam. All right. That's one way to deal with them. Farther down, we do have Demon, who puts himself further and further into the trees.
And if they stay in this pit long enough, Roshan will respawn. Does he have buyback? Nope. No buyback on 1437. They did win the Roshan fight, I think, with a 4v5 before. I wouldn't put it past Summoner's Rift to try it.
Yeah, for sure. Sniper's actually a pretty good hero to work on that Radiant side when defending Roshan. He's got all these various cliffs, especially with the Blink Dagger as well.
Yeah, he was on this cliff at first for the first time they won the Rosh fight right there. He sat on there, and with a Blink Dagger, he can even blink up over here, blink over here.
Yeah.
All business is just too much.
Arteezy.
Too much bait to work with.
Oh, nice BKB. Talera is only going to be able to dodge so much damage with that Spike Carapace. Now managed to get a right click on a Phantasmian as well.
Thanks for standing still.
Double kill for Artour thanks to the quick reaction of the BKB. Is that a BKB?
He just faded it out like up. 2 seconds. 2 seconds.
That is.
That
so
kill crazy. Is by 2 seconds. Else he would have died. Illusion. And he wouldn't have had buyback too.
And
he just acquired
means
1,800 gold in the last minute, or 30 seconds of acquiring that.
It means they can now take Roshan. This is Aegis and Aegis, actually. So, Aegis for... I don't know, it doesn't look like Artour actually wants to drop it.
Drop it, Yasha. I would drop Yasha for the Aegis, but...
Artour's like, nah, I got a Blink Dagger. I got quick reactions. I'm a star player. Just gonna rely on that.
If anything, I would give. No, everything makes sense. Like and cheese.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Centaur Aegis is okay
Radiant
too.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Finally.
Radiant's top
tier
tower.
Whoa! Jump on 1437. Sleazel actually gonna try and take him out real quickly. There goes the BKB, and Sleazel with his own BKB is decently tanky. But not enough, the direct fire of Artour. Now on the right side, we do have Goody, who's trying to deal with Demon, but he's already been taken out as well as the rest of Wheel. Only having Relic's Wind Ranger still up. And it seems like SUMSRIFT are like, alright, we're done with this game now, guys. We're gonna go ahead and end it. Yep, so there's no buyback for Wheel, so.
And this is what just happened. So, last game fight, Relic wasn't there, and Sleazel went in, 1v5.
Grants. Well, that brings our match to a close. Second game also going to Summoner's Rift. 2-0 for them. That still ends, I believe that now places them in fourth place as they're going to jump up to 11 and